Corvin, but no Ray. One of his crew?
Skill marks. There, along the floor and wall.
Weird. I guess we keep looking.
We?
I mean, I'll keep looking. No hell, no afterlife, ever.
It does not attack.
Ah. Mom made them sound more dangerous than that.
Then do not drop your guard. Come. Follow me, Andreas.
I'm on my way.
Ready yourself, boy.
Batista! Tell me when.
Your arrows will bring her down.
No ring. We're not gonna find Brock's friend alive, are we?
You
over here.
Sir. Hey, it's another treasure map.
Attached to the Soul Eater.
Well, we know what happened to Invari now. We can just go tell Brock. I don't need to fight it, right?
No, we will fight it.
But why?
Because you are frightened of it.
Yeah! Did I do okay?
A decent start. Reyes, stay focused and look for a weak point.
Yes, sir.
Stay quiet. Make no sudden movement.
Use it against them!
Alchemist. But where's the rest of him?
Ashes, most likely.
The Soul Eater got him.
Read it.
Yes, sir.
These runes were written fast. It spells out... Ejim Staney. I don't know that one.
We will ask the blue one.
So now you're interested?
We found his alchemist. A reward was promised.
What'd you find?
Your alchemist.
I'm sorry, Brock. The hand is all we could find. Still wearing the ring. There was a soul eater inside. And, well, it must have burned away the rest of him.
Suppose you'll still be wanting some compensation, huh?
Naturally.
Naturally, he says. Miani Feruxi. Maybe Anvari left a bit of magic inside for he croaked.
Dwarves can do that?
Sure, dwarves and magic jewels is like flies and pig lips. Supple ones.
Ugh. I'm not as interested as I thought.
You sticking around for grains of wisdom?
Brock, what do you know about the serpent in the lake?
I know he's too damn big.
All right.
Boy.
So, what happened when the horseman had dealt with the hunter?
He took the man's bit and bridle and allowed him to ride in the saddle on his back. Together, they killed the stag, and the horse tasted victory. But the hunter would not release the horse and made a slave of him.
So, getting revenge cost him his freedom. Hope it was worth it.
It was not.
That looks like a water wheel. Or I guess, an underwater wheel. Did you just laugh at that?
No.
You sure?
Yes. I do not laugh.
Don't I know it.
Here. Boy.
Yes, sir. Another map. Great.
I'll bring her down, just tell me when!
That's so!
We are done here.
More of those. Good.
And face me, God of Thunder!
Your challenges mean nothing to the God Spirit. They do not listen.
Do not mock my pursuit of vengeance. Though my family devoted their lives to worshipping Thor, I've devoted mine to his downfall. And I will start with that statue looming over my father's grave.
Unlikely. You are dead.
Is there something we can do?
For a reward, of course.
If you bring down the statue, you have my blessing to loot my father's grave. He rests on an island to the east.
Why do you hate Thor so much?
After my father passed, my mother built the statue to watch over his grave. Imagine our surprise when the God of Thunder himself came to offer condolences. At first we were thrilled, but he quickly took advantage of our hospitality. My mother begged him to leave, and Thor, in his drunken rage, killed her. I was left with nothing but grief. Eventually, I lost that as well, and found only rage in its place.
I'm so sorry.
Come, boy. We have a statue to destroy.
My father's grave lies on an island to the east. Do not mistake my mother's statue of Thor for that monstrous eyesore. I cannot rest while my mother's murderer stands above my father's grave.
That spirit.
The one whose mom was killed by Thor? What about him?
Let his story be a reminder. The lives of men mean nothing to the gods.
I know, Father.
You know. But do you listen?
Yes.
Good.
One more story.
Very well. There was a tale of a frog. His pond had dried up, so the frog and his son left to find a new home. They found a well. The son saw the water and made to jump in, but the father stopped him. He saw the well was deep, and once inside, they would not be able to escape if the water dried up again. Wisely, they moved on.
That's it?
Hold. We will finish that later.
Okay.
Boy.
Vaithargar. Southern outposts of the Dwarven King. Dwarven King? Have you ever heard of a Dwarven King?
No.
Hey, Brock. You ever hear of a Dwarf King?
I suppose you're talking about Motsignir? Some bitch ruled over the humans once lived in this area. Built itself a castle just north of here.
A dwarven castle? What's it like?
You got yourself a pair of eyes and legs, ain't you? Might want to stock up before you head that way, though. Old Motsignir's known for collecting all manner of killerin' creatures. Not sure who's looking after him now.